to run it as a formal business. We were tinkering around with the technology, and one thing led to another. We ended up using drones for the general elections exactly 5 years ago from now, in 2014. And that's when we actually realized the scope that the technology has. At that time, back in India, the only real way to get an aerial shot that meant anything was using a full-fledged helicopter, which of course had its own logistical nightmares, and it was extremely expensive. We found a way to do it much cheaper and much more efficiently, and that's essentially how Quidich started. As we grew into the company, as we got more people on board, we realized that the potential of drone technology is far beyond just simple aerial filming. And that's when we started expanding into enterprise operations. So for the longest time, until about a year ago, we were doing a bunch of enterprise operations around survey, around real estate, around progress monitoring, inspection, etc. And we've kind of dabbled in all possible applications that there are using drones worldwide. Because when you're talking about deliveries, for example, for an Amazon, you're talking about hundreds and thousands of drones flying the sky on an everyday basis. And then them having safe landing spots, safe spots to take off from, a bunch of regulatory things need to come in place in terms of privacy. So all of these things are essentially part of a much larger ecosystem that need to be thought of. Now the good part of the Indian regulations is that they are thinking about this. So we are currently at a 1.0 sort of version with the regulations. I know that the 2.0 version that's coming out is going to open up slightly more in terms of allowing deliveries to happen, in terms of allowing at least experiments with deliveries to happen. With deliveries, you need to typically fly beyond visual line of sight. Drones need to be completely autonomous, and you know, that's really when the technology also is going to be able to achieve its full potential. So for example, we're now at a phase where we're in India at least, where we're living in the concept of one drone, one operator, which are all semi-autonomous drones. But at the pace at which technology is advancing, these drones don't really need an operator anymore. So we're gradually going to move to a system where many drones for one operator, and eventually to many drones with no operators when we're fully autonomous. And that's when the full economic potential of this technology can be exploited. Currently, our core business is threefold. Our main business, that's our highest revenue generating, is sport broadcast. We started off using drones for real-time live broadcast on all the sports that you watch on TV. We're currently doing the IPL for the BCCI. What we managed to do is that we found blaring gaps in the sport broadcast industry that we've tried to plug in. So from only having drones as an aerial technology platform and providing a service to these clients, we now actually operate in a domain which is special cameras. These special cameras are essentially remotely piloted and stabilized. So currently for the IPL, we also run a sort of a buggy system, which is, you know, essentially an unmanned car which has solid suspension, on which we mounted a camera and a stabilization system. And we're able to provide shots from really low angle, you know, that other equipment that they use for sports can't do. So a cricket match at the IPL typically has more than 30 cameras operating simultaneously, but then in that we've been able to find gaps that we can plug in using our expertise with stabilized camera systems. So that's our largest revenue generator right now. We have clients like Star, like 10, like Sony, etc., who we do all of their sport broadcasts for. We have a tech team now that's essentially building a layer of technology on top of these hardware systems that we have. So we're building something called augmented reality on the drone, which is something that is essentially being able to build graphics for broadcast that can interact with the movement of the camera. This is something that exists currently only for wired cameras. It doesn't exist for wireless cameras at all. So once we've built this technology perfectly on the drone, we can migrate it to our other remote platforms that we currently use. We do aerial cinematography, which is essentially largely we do almost all of the Bollywood films that happen in the country today. We're for Dharma, for XL, we're basically their go-to drone company. Currently, we're doing vertical asset inspections, and we're doing a bunch of inspections around telecom towers across India to try and digitize those legacy telecom towers. We kind of try and take on one new enterprise project every 3 to 4 months, and try and solve a problem from not just the angle of the drone, but from an overall ecosystem angle. So where, you know, we're using the right software, the right hardware to try and build a solution for an enterprise client, which will essentially at the end of the day save him money and make his process more efficient.